Assalamu alaikum rahmatullah. Dear viewers, welcome back. And we're still talking about good neighbors. So you could call us as well if you want to share your experience. I'm going to go straight back to James. We finished off with James, and let's begin with James. James, if you could share with the neighbors, good neighbors, I'm sure there are some plenty good neighbors around. Also, the difficult ones, if you could share it from yourself.
Right off there. So they're our current house that we moved into about a year ago. And so many of our neighbors have just been so kind to us, of bringing us over food. I love it that, you know, different celebrations, that Christmas, you know, our Muslim neighbors will still bring us, you know, gifts of food and things like that. And during, you know, during Ramadan, we get invited to iftar meals or Eid. You know, I just love that. It's just the sort of knock on the door, and this huge plate of food is sort of given to us, or being invited around to the home. So I love that, being invited into people's lives to celebrate what they're celebrating. And I suppose the opposite of that as well, you know, some of our neighbours that do keep themselves or just want the best for themselves, so don't care what happens in the block, you know, don't sweep up when they've made a mess, or do you mean it's, I think it's that just...
Has anyone annoyed you? Because you're good in size, man. Has anyone annoyed you?
No.
Okay.
No. But I think it's that. It's that focus of what you're about. And I think it is that temptation. We all live busy lives. It's easy to sort of want to just keep your head down and sort of focused on what you're doing. It's like, oh, I need to, I don't know, get the kids to school. I need to get to work. But it's easy then to block out the care for others. But if we're all caring for each other, if everyone's looking out for their neighbour, then everyone is going to be cared for. Do you see what I mean? That the quality of life for all will be better if you're putting that effort into to care for your neighbours, especially when it is so easy for... especially, I know, the elderly to be isolated. You know, you could easily an elderly neighbour next door to fall or something. And if you're not taking the care to see if they're there, then, you know, much greater problems than a community that is perhaps the more traditional community, or, you know, talking about rural areas where people are looking out for, people know their neighbours, people know their names. I think it doesn't take much effort for that sense of community to grow.
Amazing. When I moved into my new place, actually, 5 years ago, and I told my boys, listen, it's our target in the first week is we're going to know everybody in the building.
Yeah.
So how would you do that? So don't worry, let's find a way. So if I see someone carrying something, excuse me, can I help you? I know she won't even let me have it because she can carry it. No, are you here new? Yes, I am new, that number. Would you like to come and have a tea, coffee, anything like that? And I said to my sons, listen, that's the way you have to make friends. And that's where you're going to be safe as well. So you're not going to be, I don't know my neighbours anymore.
Yeah.
And he really, really worked for me, actually. Sheikh, can I come to you? And yes. I want to know, I know you're not going to have a bad neighbour, because you always say hello and hi. And so even if it's a bad, you will make him into good. Yeah, I'm sure you've done that. I want to know something about your young age. Something with neighbours. Your friend doesn't know.
Of course, yes. I put everything on the Facebook, of course, but I devoted myself to Islam when I was since young. Of course, I've been around the 40 years where I'm living, and when I came about 20 years, and I find it at that time. Of course, at that time when I came to this country, I find it the English people, they were so lovely, so generous, so kind. Even the police has so kind. Hello, say good morning. You know the bobs or the gold bills or whatever. So, and it's changed completely at the moment. After 40 years, I can see changed. I remember, of course, a box, it was a Christmas, a box was by the door of my neighbor. They were English, of course. We were in the rural area. Not that many foreigners was here. We were very few, not that many, just to say foreigner. And for a month was there. And for every we said, can I look after it? We'll take it home and look after it. I said, no, perhaps we leave it. It was there. And of course, when the neighbor came, I said, we looked after it. Okay. I said, thank you. But in general, it's good to have a good neighbor. Of course, many neighbors, I had my wife, of course, when we married, we get a celebration for all the neighbors to come. All the English, of course, at that time, all came, and we made him some good food, you know, some traditional food. And they enjoyed. Since that time, of course, my wife was, may Allah bless her soul, she died, of course, some time ago she died. But she was so popular with the neighbors. We give food and take, especially month of Ramadan. I told my daughter to the whole city. They give whole the city a sweets in the month of Ramadan. Sweets and is a tradition. They all, and suddenly they bring, when the plate come back, there's some flower in there, some that in there, some nice. Beautiful thing they give. That's a spiritual day of the neighbor to know. And everybody's smile, just say hello, of course. And when she died, of course, when she was in hospital, they were all the neighbors, God knows, I'm not telling a lie, all the neighbors queuing in the hospital to get a time to go and see her. Mm. She was unconscious, but they holding her. They were Christian, they were Jews, they are non-Muslim, they're Buddhist. They go and they love to hold their hand and pray for her.
Aww.
And it was so nice, all the hospital, around the 1,500 lady came, mm-hmm. because she was rebirthed. 1,500 lady came in for her funeral. It was amazing. The mosque, they couldn't get the man in there. It was that many women in there. But these are the sake of neighbor from everywhere. And of course, as I said, even the bishop. Archbishop wrote, I'm sorry about that. And bishop came to her funeral, to the mosque, sitting down with the many of the counselor, many of all said, this was a good lady.
Mm.
This was a lovely lady. In general, of course, we help. I haven't got anything to hide from the people, but we have a good neighbors. But sometimes we get a not good neighbors because they change. You know, the neighbor every 2 months, 3 months, they change a bigger, because they're rented.
Yeah.
Houses are all rented. Mm. And before you say salam to one, and how are you, another will come. But again, we have some bad neighbor as well. If Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if you have got a bad neighbor, because sometimes somebody take his old, he had a bad neighbor, and he take his old stuff and put it in the middle of the street and say, I don't want to be with that neighbor. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam looked and he said, why are you doing that? He says, yes, it's a bad neighbor. And I told the neighbor. Neighbor apologized and they gone back. But of course we have few neighbor, and the Prophet, peace be upon him, says, God says, Allah says, if you do good to your neighbor, you go to paradise. If your neighbor is bad and do bad to you, but you hold it, don't take against him. This is a key to paradise as well. That means if you have a bad neighbor, just say hello. If they throw something in your house or whatever or damage, just say peace, peace, peace. And they will stop.
If I ask you, sir, where do you get all your time from? How did you end up in Oxford University, Imam?
Oxford University, of course, I loved to educate. When I came to this country, you believe me, many come says, I'm saying it straight, many come and say, Sheikh, why did you come here? Are you came for work? Are you came for that? Because somebody says, when I came, my father had a tuppence. And now I'm a millionaire, multimillionaire. Another one comes and says, my father was living in a cardboard. Very common, now I'm a millionaire. I said, no, mine was. I brought the money. I educate myself here and educate the people. And still I'm learning and I'm teaching. This is my way. I did not come for work. I came to educate these people on that way. And I came to learn from them as well. And I'm doing it exactly.
And until I die. What a place you've been to? Oxford.
Of course. Oxford is the best place. It's called Madinatul Ilm. All in there, and of course, a very intelligent Muslim. We got a very intelligent people. And God bless them all. It doesn't matter. Anywhere we go, they're all brothers and all friends. And I love you all. Brilliant. For the sake of Allah.
I want to come back to you, just to know your list of famous people you met.
Every time I see him, actually, he is meeting some amazing people.
Mm. Someone from UN last few weeks ago, and he was talking about him.
Mm.
Rob, if I come to you, sir. As a young person, I'm talking about you are young. Has anyone inspired to what you're doing now as inspirational person or role model to you, and that really helped you? Because our young people are always helped when they look up to something. You know, has they worked with you like this? Or
I think there are a few different people who I
you could
I
name them.
From.
It would be great. They will be happy if you want to name them.
There was a vicar who's passed to the other world now. But he was very much a community vicar who visited and cared for the people in the community and really took responsibility. And many times he wasn't very good at sermons, but actually because he was constantly giving to the community, going to the hospital, caring for people. His sermons had real content. They really had depth. So people didn't matter if he muttered a little bit, that actually what he said was very, very profound. I think the founder of a movement, Father Moon, he also is very much a dynamic person and a very giving person. I think he really pushed all of us to really love people of different backgrounds and to go to other countries to serve and to love and to care for other people and to
So how did it come about, the Universal Peace Federation? How did that come about? And what's their aim and what's your plans?
I think 10 years ago it started, or 12 years ago it started. It has consultative status with the United Nations. It was started in New York. The idea of particularly bringing religion and politics together to have a better decision-making process, a better understanding, a better dialogue within decision-making, and also to promote good families, families that will nurture peaceful citizens, peaceful global citizens. So the idea of Universal Peace Federation is a set of principles by which people of all backgrounds, all faiths, can work together. And we can work together for the good of all humanity.
Are you saying you're working with UN, or you just had some advice from them? Is there a project of UN? Or
we have a consultative status with the Economic and Social Council of UN, and
support of UN.
We support the a number of UN days, particularly in our yearly program. So a couple of weeks ago was World Interfaith Harmony Week, and we were considering anti-radicalization, and Sheikh Ramzi was. Good enough to speak very profoundly that during that time. And next one, International Women's Day, and commemoration of the Holocaust, but also raising genocide awareness, to raise awareness of crimes against humanity and to campaign for many different crimes against humanity, so looking at human rights issues around the world. So these different days we hold, and we bring many top levels speakers to raise awareness of these issues, and we will campaign on different issues during the year. We went many times also to the Middle East with peace delegations. I went about 20 times.
How did you meet Sheikh Ramzi? How was your first impression?
Different activities. Oh,
was it funny first time?
Oh, he's very outgoing and very dynamic and very.
It's the first time I'm seeing him today, but it's almost like I know him for a long, long time.
Yes. He's a director of our Universal Peace Federation in the UK, so
thank you very much.
We benefit from his
advice
a lot.
We are honored. Thank you very much. Very
brilliant for sharing your information. It's amazing to know. James, do we need role models for our young people or young community? And why do we need it anyway, if we need it?
I think it's very important to have, from especially as I was saying earlier.
Did you have any yourself?
Yeah. But just say, I think from your own community as well, so that it's not just that you're looking outside of your own culture to find it, but actually from within. And so for people in the community to stand up and to speak positively, to act in certain ways, so that they can model for the younger generation. I think my role models growing up have always been people that their actions reflect what they're saying. I think being a follower of Jesus, the power of who he is was that his actions 100% reflected the words that he was saying. You know, the words that he was sort of preaching were backed up by the care for the individuals that he was sort of coming in contact with.
You know, you mentioned Jesus. You know, just to say, you know, we love Jesus because we're Muslims.
Absolutely.
You know, it's something is missing. People don't know. People saying, oh, no. We love him because we're Muslims. We have to. We've got no choice. Mm. And he is the person to love as well. It's no other way.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah. And so I suppose I've always been drawn to sort of people of faith who have a similar heart, who perhaps aren't recognised, but go about the work that they do of loving their neighbours without reward, or but seeing that the faith that they have, a bit like you were saying earlier, of that their relationship with God is inseparable from their relationship with others, that they cannot be a follower of Jesus if they're not loving their neighbour. And so, I mean, on a global stage, sort of growing up here, seeing on sort of in the 80s of like Mother Teresa on the streets of Calcutta, you know, caring for the sick and saying, well, I'm just called to do this because of my faith. Mm. And someone like a lady called Jackie Pullinger, who still works out in on Hong Kong with sort of addicts out there, of devoting her whole life living amongst these people. But there's one story of when I was in my 20s, and I spent some time out just in Reading, just outside of London, and I met this young man who was only slightly older than me. And he had decided to move on to a local council estate because he saw he was a youth worker and saw these young men who were growing up often like just being raised by their mothers, you know, sort of single parents. And were getting in all kinds of trouble because they didn't have these role models, didn't have positive role models in lives. And I was really struck by him. So he moved onto this estate, not choosing to live somewhere sort of nice. And he actually set up a gardening business. He, with his own money, he had just a few £1,000 worth of saving, and he bought a van. And there was these two young men, I went and helped them out one day, and they were had been thrown out of school, sort of 16 years old, getting into lots of trouble. And they had no gardening experience at all. And yet to give them a bit of ownership, he sort of set up this business for them. He bought them mobile phones so that they felt this is my business, I'm doing it. But each day he would go and knock on their doors at sort of 7 a.m. saying, God, you need to get up, we'll get them up, get them in the van, would drive them to the job, would set them doing their work. He would then go to his job all day, then would come back at the end of the day, pick them up, take them home. But then he would have to go back to the people that they'd been doing the work in the garden for and apologize because they'd done often a terrible job. You know, he was trying to encourage them to say, you can do this. But often, you know, they would cut trees at the wrong height. So he'd then spend his evening fixing whatever they'd done wrong. And no one saw him do this. He invested all of his money, his savings, in these just couple of young men to try and, to make a difference in their lives, to stop that sort of generational spiral down, to say, no, these young men are worth in investing in ways loving, and no one saw him do it apart from me. I went and spent some time with him, and I just loved that. I was like, wow, to someone to invest that level of day and night into these young men who weren't grateful. They just, you know, they didn't turn up for work. It was terrible, but that love and seeing that I am called to love these people and to show them a different way is possible. I was amazed by it.
That's the beauty of loving somebody and sharing, you know, the love you have. It shows you another direction, actually. Sheikh, if I ask you your role model, if you name one person, and apart from Muhammad, of course, he's our role model, apart from him, actually, if you name one person,
we have many role models all over the world. And of course we have our sheikhs, our scholars, our muftis. These are many of them, our role models. I cannot say who
one
is
one person.
One person you want to see is myself. I'm a very role model for all because I'm sure all the muftis, all the sheikh say, Sheikh, you're right. Because if I distinguish between that friend and that friend, however, what I would like to say, the role model for this country has to be somebody's fish born in this country and go with the culture of this country. You know, it's very important. For example, we have in Saudi Arabia they got culture. We have in Malaysia they got their own culture. We have in Syria they got their own culture. We have in UK which they should have their own culture. Through that, the role model come, which hundreds of thousands of Muslims come behind that. Not one here and one here and bring a division and separation. we live in this country, and we have to work within this country. We have to adopt what we have in this country, okay? And the adoption of the everything is the same. Everything is Islam. When he came, the Islam came, he did not change the traditions at all. He sat on the top of the tradition. For that reason, Bangladeshi got their own clothes and Islam was on top. Pakistanis got their own clothes, Islam on top. That's a, for example, the Malaysian got a, and all Islam on. Therefore, what we need to do, if we have the Islam in UK, we have to find the proper tradition of the Islam, tradition of the culture of country, and after that, Islam sit on them very simply. Therefore, to have a role model again, many brothers are there, but they doing a good job. They doing a good job, and hopefully looking after our youth. Your youth going wrong. I can see them. They going wrong, and I'm suffering for that.
There's two sides to it. I mean, yes. Recently, I don't know if you know, there are a lot of young Muslim boys and girls. I know making food for homeless people. They integrating with it, you know, really well. They do a lot of charities. They're going around the world giving charities well. And I think Muslim Aid, Islamic Relief are helping bringing young people in. I mean, we haven't seen that 10 years ago actually. So that's the beauty of it.
Of course.
And education has gone very, very high for especially for Muslim youth. They're doing very, very well. So I'm sure you guys played a role. Definitely, you guys played a role. And it's a good thing to see. Even in Whitechapel, you will see a lot of young people, what they're doing nowadays. Mm. They haven't done it before.
It is very important because Islam cares. At that time, we may not have enough homeless. At the moment, you can see the homeless suddenly shoot up because the houses are very expensive. Mm. And sometime between the father and the family, you know, especially in the Christian, which you have to sort it out, your Christian yourself. Because when you get 18, the parent says, okay, now you are 18, you go, and we have to have our life. In the Islamic tradition, usually say, son, you bring your wife here in another corner, and build a little bit more, sitting together and looking after the older. Because the problem at the moment with the senior citizens, which all are in a hospital, they haven't got the families. They have a lot of families, but family says, you've done your life, let me do my life. But life, therefore, what we need to do, we need to care for all. Care for all of these, and of course, help each other. We have a very good tradition. We have to keep that tradition, which all together, all families together, we are all as one family.
Why is it, do you think it's an issue? Like, we have a lot of imams from outside the country. They came in, they don't speak English. A lot of places, not all. It's changing. It's a good thing, it's changing. Mm-hmm. But they come in with a different tradition. And they don't speak English. When they give khutbah, a lot of young people don't understand these things. So you, in a position that you can change things, you know, especially MCB playing a big role, like Minab and... training a lot of young imams. That's so right. What can we do?
What we have, of course, tradition, of course, is a very tradition which they have to say it in Arabic, but tradition in this country which we say English and Arabic. Of course, we say, if you have to say a little bit Arabic, we translate it for them to understand. Otherwise, many of them, they don't understand. Many of them, for example, when the imam talk Pakistani or Bangladeshi, many of the Arabs, they don't understand. Therefore, for the imam, they must, imam has a sixth condition. So have to have the imam, imam of the Friday prayer. Have to very good speaker and know the language of general. Therefore, imam has to deliver. If the imam does not deliver for the people to understand, and if the people does not understand what imam delivered, there is no prayer. Salat is batal. Salat is no good. Therefore, if even one word, if even one hadith, even one narration of the Prophet, they understand, I deliver it to you, understand it, and we don't. But this, at that time, because the people repeat, all the imams repeat something which they don't know themselves, what is this, what they need to do. And young people, I looked. I'm as imam. I got at least 200 khutbah in the Facebook. The children, I look. For example, the students or the young people, they do not come to the prayer. They come to the prayer. They stay by the door, playing with the things because they don't understand what they say. And as soon as the Allah Akbar, the Salat come, they stay. They do not. Over a billion people come Friday to prayer all over the world. If had a billion hour, is hour, 1 hour. Yeah, billion hour, the Islam was flourished to the sky. You understand what I'm saying? But we do not deliver, Imam like me, do not deliver for these children. Allah says, you must go there. Do you understand what I'm saying? Allah says, you must go there, but we cannot deliver. It's our fault, fault of our Imams, including myself, which we don't deliver to youth. Youth, what they want is the current. Current things, issues has to be solved out. Not 1,000 years ago. We are not going to go back. Islam is a forward. It does not go backward. We are getting advice from the past, but we're going forward because advice will be built for 1,000 years of the in future.
Thank you. I think it's really, really important you shared. We only got 5 more minutes left. So if I could
ask, need to do some dua as well. Remember?
Inshallah. The last minute, you put the dua for us. Yeah. James, we only got 5 minutes left. If I ask you, do you have Muslim friends in local and how do you find them?
Just to generalize.
What was your expectation, and has that met? Because we live together. You know, we live in a UK, it's an amazing place to live, honestly. Diversity and everything else.
Yeah.
But are we doing the bit? Because if we are, if you want to change, we've got to do our bit. So do you find?
I think living in East London is a very unique place within the UK, as we were talking about earlier. London is not the UK. And so, you know, living in Whitechapel, you can't avoid being friends with Muslims unless you keep your head down and don't speak to anyone. And so, yes, I have lots of Muslim friends. You know, when I take my sons to school and I'm talking to parents at the school gates, when just talking to my neighbours, you know, constantly around them. So they're, I think it's... You have to be careful when we're talking about, you know, it's easy to focus on the faith rather than the culture. I think a big thing is just adapting different culture in the same way as if I moved up to Scotland, I'd be adjusting to a different culture. It'd be a more similar culture because they're sort of neighbouring countries. And so I think when I did move to East London, there was an expectation that I was moving into a different culture and my desire was to learn, like you were saying a few moments ago, actually, learning from that culture. Obviously, hopefully, there's things that we can share with our neighbours. But if I didn't want to learn from my Bangladeshi neighbours, I wouldn't have come to East London. Yeah. Do you mean there's a richness of culture, the care for the families, all these things. It's that desire for something. I love travelling. It's that desire to learn. Mm.
You've got 20 seconds to say something to your viewers. Last word from you.
No pressure.
Or something. I hope God.
I think it's just a simple message of to look for that richness amongst your neighbours. We live in such a diverse neighbourhood, a diverse part of the world, so there's a real opportunity that is missing from other parts of the world where we have this richness of cultures, this richness of ideas, and to not be afraid of that, not to be afraid to ask your neighbours, your friends, what some of those differences are. They won't be offended. They'd love to talk about their faith. They'd love to talk about their culture. Mm. So just have confidence and enjoy the richness of that community.
Fantastic. Mm. If I could come to Robin, just for your 1 minute now, your reflection, and how do you want to see the universe and your aim of world, if you could say to our viewers, especially young people are watching.
I think our faith is not a barrier for other faiths. We can experience God through other faiths. My experience of hearing the call to prayer is so precious to hear. I went to Al-Aqsa Mosque. I went to the place of the Mirage one time, and it was such a precious experience. These places allowed me to feel God in a different way. So I think faith is not a barrier. It's something that can enhance and broaden our experience of life and humanity and build richness.
Fantastic. Sheikh, your dua in 30 seconds of 50
yes.
Seconds.
What I would like to say, of course, to the young, my brothers, my little brothers and sisters, enjoy yourself. Enjoy yourself because Islam allow you to enjoy as much as you can, but don't forget your prayer and don't forget you are a good Muslim. Shall I do it?
Yes, please.
In Allahumma malaikatuhu yusalluna ala nabi ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallamu taslima. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد آمين. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد آمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين آمين. إن شاء الله إن شاء الله may Allah bless you all, may Allah give you long life, health and wealth and happiness and house you in paradise, inshallah. Amen.
Jazakumullahu khair. Dear viewers, I'm sure you enjoyed it. And Sheikh at the end made the prayer for everyone and all human beings. That makes a lovely evening. And if we said anything wrong, please do forgive us. We're just trying to learn and give our some. So make dua for us. I'll see you next week, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam.